things.
For me, it was probably the most important encounter I ever had. I mean, musically, I was completely crazy for him also when I was a little girl, when I heard him in Argentina. He was something, I had never heard something like that.
1930年、ウィーンで生まれたフリードリッヒ・グルダ。生粋のウィーンの音楽家として、モーツァルトからシューベルトに至る古典派の作品を得意としました。しかし彼には全く別の一面があったのです。
Für mich ist normal, also für den Musiker, der ich im Laufe der Jahre geworden bin, ist meine, das ganze Feld der Musik umfassende musikalische Tätigkeit normal.Und für manche andere ist es vielleicht ein Skandal, aber ich empfinde das nicht als Skandal. Für mich ist das normal. Alle Musiker auf der...
Yeah. Does it come as a surprise?
I think you should have stayed longer. Yeah. It would have worked, maybe.
No, he looks very nice.
今回のコンサートにはグルダの息子で同じくピアニストのパウルとリコも参加します。グルダとの思い出が3人を結びつけています。アルゲリッチは13歳から1年半の間、ウィーンでグルダにピアノのレッスンを受けました。グルダと過ごした時間は多感な少女に大きな影響を与えました。
He recognized me, which was horrible for me. So he said, why are you so green? I was green because of fear, you know. He was very nice. Then he told me, in order to make me feel better, that he didn't know very wellhis pieces that he had to play. Your father was telling me, you should stay with me like 2 years or 3 years maximum, not more, because you are starting to play like me, the same, and then people will notice because I play in public.
レッスンを通して結ばれた信頼は生涯変わることがありませんでした。しかし師匠グルダの指導はなかなか手厳しかったようです。
It is very difficult. So now that's, you know.
To pull off, you mean? Yeah.
Yes, and I couldn't.
Yes, it is difficult.
I was more about a month about that, and he told me, well, Argerich, I thought you were talented, but maybe I'm wrong. I was wrong.
Yeah.
And so he gave him for next week. So, Gaspard and me, I'm a quiet tenor, and I got it right. So he was very happy, I remember. But when he told me that, I thought you were talented, but maybe I was wrong. You know?
Psychological measure.
Yes!
Very drastic psychological.
Yeah. Yes.
パウルとリコにとっては、グルダは父であると同時に尊敬する音楽家でもあります。
As I said, he would speak through music. It has a, it is composed with love, and I can feel that. And as I said, this is the strongest way he could show his love with, through music. It was inspired by me, and he made a musical photo of me.
While he was very serious also, he was very serious about the music and he really gave everything he had. But also he loved to have fun with music, okay? I will do a little bit of improvisation in that part. Something that I don't know yet what I will do, because he was like that. He always improvised at performance. So to really remember him, one has to do that as well. Not everything can be planned.
ドリヒ・グルダメモリアルコンサート、最後を飾るのはモーツァルトのピアノ協奏曲第20番未単調です。アルゲリッチがこの曲を日本で演奏するのは初めてですが、これはグルダが最も得意としていた一曲。普段のコンサートとは別の緊張がアルゲリッチを包みます。2人の息子の視線を浴びながら何度も同じフレーズを確認します。
Yes, I'm very afraid. He used to play it wonderfully, of course, but not me. So I feel a little bit ashamed, a bit, you know, because it's, I don't know. Well, but I try. I mean, I try what I can, you know.